Welcome to the candy shop.
Yeah. So seductive. I take you to the candy shop.
All right, gentlemen. Welcome to the week three video. Jeremy was unable to do it, so your boy is back in action for 1 week, unless, you know, he needs me again. And, you know, let's get after it. Exciting couple of weeks. I'm going to show you the setup real quick. Why not, you know? You know, I got the Jackie's work set up. Baxter is here. Baxter, say hello. All right. Good. He's normal. All right, let's discuss some shit, shall we? Week three is approaching quickly in a couple of hours, as a matter of fact. And I wanted to go over some shit. Let's start with the standings. Here. There's two divisions, Division 1 and Division 2. And there's a clear powerhouse division, which would be Division Toe, Joe Toe. Led right now by James Hanchu, fucking getting it in at 2-0. Everyone else is 1-1. And then the probably going to win that division would be Matt. And then you got the rest of them. Spawn at 1-1, Bobby 1-1, and then Chris and Mr. Russo at 0-2. Not having great starts, but looking to improve. If you're looking for the points for, James, unsurprisingly has the most points for at 266. The least amount is 173 by Mr. Russo. That's like a 100-point difference. So that would be the best, and that would be the worst as of right now. Let's see who's getting extremely unlucky. Jeremy would be the one getting extremely unlucky so far. He's still 1-1, but he has allowed the most points at 260. So... all right, man, that's where we stand with that. So let's go into that one thing that says where the teams are going to finish. Let me find that. Hope everyone's doing well. You know, I'm doing good, so I hope all of you are. So the trending up, man, and I have to agree with ESPN on this one. Fuck, it's Steve. Steve, the fucking, the making the money last week. Well, $5 because I took my 20. So now I can finally shut the fuck up about this Ryan Fitzpatrick thing. Steve has definitely been the most improved team. Looks strong. Mike Evans will be out this week, but he has a strong roster nonetheless. And then you got James. He went up to... so Steve says, let's see, where he's going to place now in fifth, I guess. James bumped up a couple of spots. I'm assuming he'll be first. Yep. And then Matt also bumping up a couple of spots. And then on the downhill trend, the only team on there appears to be Mr. Russo going down three spots to dead last. So, all right. So we did the standings. We did the final projections. Let's get into a little recap of last week. Load up the old scoreboard here. I don't remember what Jeremy picked at all. So I'll just kind of go over the scores. I fucking annihilated Chris, 98-84. High scoring affair in that one. Spawny, 121 over Bobby at 85. I know Bobby's team statistically doesn't look very well, like points wise, but if you look at his roster, it's actually pretty damn good. We'll go over it a little bit later, but I don't think his roster is as bad as his score makes it out to be. But you know what would look really good on your roster? Zeke Elliott. And you'll never guess who has him. Let's just move on, though. Shane and then Big Ass TDs got beat up pretty good here by James Hanchu, 138-102. Again, that moved James to 2-0 and Shane to 1-1. If I got to be honest, man, these guys are definitely... The two top guys over the last few years. I feel like they're both having a lot of success, and it looks like they're going to continue to do so this year. Suck up on my cup, that would be Matt. Beat Mr. Russo barely, 103-97. So Matt got kind of lucky, not scoring many points, but was still able to pull it out, kind of like me. I don't pull out, but you know what I mean. All right, let's keep going. 4 score and 7 beers ago. Got annihilated by Steve, and thank heaven it's Evans. That moved Steve to 1-1, and he is now second in our division. Okay. And that's that. So in that, and 152-92, Steve took home the high score with 152. So cut him a check for $5 on it via Venmo. And then, you know, he paid his due back to me. And feels good. Feels good. You know, that was a 10-year thing. Anyway. The only trade that has happened yet this year did not involve Chris Russell at all. Or Bobby. It is Spawn and Mr. Russo. I forgot exactly what it was. Let me see if I can find it. Sorry for the pause. It was Mr. Russo trading Clyde Edwards-Helaire to Spawn for Rashad Bateman. So I don't think that'll be the trade that wins anybody the league. But it was a trade nonetheless. So I figured we'd discuss that. So let's go into this week's games. I'm trying to move it a little bit faster. I feel like at this point, last time I was doing videos, we'd be like 18 and a half minutes in. And we're only like 6. So I'm feeling pretty damn good about the progress that I'm making here. So let's go into this week's matchups. I have not looked at anything. I'll pick a game of the week. Let's see. I mean, obviously my game versus Steve. Well, you know, a lot of history there. Very close game, too. Oh, James and Bobby. That's a good game of the week. You know what? It is obvious. It is obvious what the game of the week is. It just fucking struck me. It will be Mr. Russo, Seymour Snatch versus Scats, Tats, Chris fucking Russell. Let's load it up. Let's load it up. The battle of 0-2. Someone is going to go to 0-3. This shit annoys me. It's like, do you really need to fucking do a video? Motherfucker, dude. No. All right. I can't see anything until this fucking ad ends. So, but it's like, yeah, you could pick a couple 2-0 teams, couple 1-1 teams, but when you got the battle of 0-3 coming, because the loser has a very minimal chance probably at making the playoffs. So, big game for these guys. Let's kind of go over their rosters real quick. Currently, it's a very close game, 105-104. It has Mr. Russo winning. I don't know if Herbert is going to be able to play efficiently with that rib injury. Derrick Henry's looking to bounce back. Man, Mr. Russo has got some strong fucking running backs. It's his receiving core that's definitely killing him this year. Yep, that's why it makes sense why he traded for Rashad Bateman then, doesn't it? Hockenson, questionable. Not sure what's going on with him. Won't let me load it up. So that is what it is. All right. And then on the and then he's got Keenan Allen on the bench. It looks like Gabe Davis said he's going to play too. Okay, so he's Mr. Russo's got a good-looking team, actually, if guys would get healthy now that I look at it. Because you add Keenan Allen and Gabe Davis to that roster, it's not DK Metcalf and Deontay Johnson. It's looking pretty damn good. I don't know what you're doing with the Seahawks defense at all. I'm not saying I'm like a fantasy guru or anything. I wouldn't go that route. That's just my opinion, but I respect it. On the other side, you got Chris Russell, who decided not to start the Buccaneers defense last week and lost against your boy. He's starting the Buccaneers defense this week, though. He's got Tom Brady going against Green Bay. I don't know how I feel about that one, but he doesn't really have any other options, so it looks like that's going to be the route he goes. Najee and Chubb, man, battle of the running backs here. He's kind of weak at that wide receiver position as of now. He's got Julio McLaurin. I'm going to have to take Mr. Russo in this one. I think Keenan Allen, he might not play, but when Gabe Davis enters his lineup, it makes it a little bit better. And I think he is, if he, okay, here's what I'll say. If he takes the Seahawks defense out, Mr. Russo wins. If he leaves the Seahawks defense in, Chris wins. That'll be the route I go. All right, let's go over the other games real quick. So that's our game of the week, the Battle of 0-3. All right, let's get right to it. We got Steve, thank heaven, it's Evans versus myself, the Double Orgasm Knights, the best team name ever fucking invented, longest reigning coach. We are ready to go. Steve has got a damn good team this year, no doubt about it. Lamar, Eckler, Diggs is fucking killing it. Hopefully he got it all out of the system the last couple weeks, because goddamn, I think Sutton's the only receiver left. Higbee, I guess, would be his weakness right now. He got Garrett Wilson. Thank God I dropped him. So now he's putting him in. And then when he fucking destroys me, it's going to make me feel that much worse. So right now it's got Steve winning by 0.2 points total. 111.5 to 111.3. Let's see. On my side, we got Russell Wilson, who was taking a shit all season. McCaffrey, who apparently has decided to go out with a season-ending ankle injury, if I had to guess today. Zeke underperforming. It's not. I got Travis Kelce. That's about the only position I think Jeff Wilson. I know Garrett Wilson had a great week last week, but I want to give the advantage there to Jeff Wilson. I feel pretty confident in my defense, but his defense looks good too. I'm gonna have to give this one to Steve. Unfortunately, I gotta be honest. It's not looking great for me. I don't know why it has this game so close. But I guess we'll see. Maybe, hopefully, it's smarter than me and it's right. So, all right. Let me see you, TDs. James versus Bobby. Fucking epic matchup here. It's like the Rodgers versus Brady right here. So, on James's side, he's 2-0, I believe. Bobby's 1-1. James, he's got Hurts. He's been killing it. Swift's been killing it. Jefferson's going to kill it. Hill's been killing it. Yeah, he's... goddamn. I like this. I like what he's doing here. I don't know if we've ever really seen this in Beef's Bowl history. He is going double tight end. He's got Kyle Pitts in the tight end slot and then Georgie Kittle in the flex position. In the flex. He's picking him over Allen Robinson. So I guess I see it. It makes sense. Devonta Smith looks like he might be a good option this week, but yeah, I make sense why he's doing it. If George Kittle can play, he can put up big numbers, no doubt about that. Right now, it's got James projected to win 116 to 108. And now, I was talking about Bobby's roster before. You know, I looked at it. I don't think it's as bad as his record is. Oh, no, he's one. No, sorry, he's 1-1. But I think he's got like a low amount of points scored or something like that. Anyway, I don't want to click onto the other screen. It takes too much time. But I think Bobby's got a pretty damn good team, man. I think Kirk Cousins, I mean, just bench him if he's on Monday or Sunday Night Football. We know that. So, but he's going to have a bounce back week this week. You got Mixon, Kamara. If Kamara comes back, Michael Thomas and Kamara on the same team. I don't know about that too much, but I guess I understand why you got to start him. Amon-Ra St. Brown's been fucking slaying puss this year. He tried trading me DJ Moore. I politely declined. I fucking hate that guy. Cousins a good backup. I forgot he lost Dak Prescott. He also lost Schultz, so that's why he's got Irv Smith. Pretty good backup there. So I am going to go with the upset here. I really do. I like Bobby's team. I think a lot of his guys are going to blow up this week. Mixon against the Jets is a good matchup. Amon-Ra's been fucking slaying. I think Cousins is going to put up 20 at least. Cowboys defense is a good defense to have this week. I think it's going to be a close game, but I think Bobby's going to take this one. Suck up on my cup versus Matthew Sponathan. It's right now, it's got Sponathan winning 115 to 107. So Matt at 2-0, Spawn at 1-1. Maybe Spawn's got the better team. Let's check it the fuck out. Yep. Matt's got Carson Wentz in the starting lineup. So I get it, but man, is that fucking scary. Saquon, Damian Pierce starting this week. Cooper Kupp's all right. Pittman, is he going to play? I guess maybe he will, Dylan. All right. See who's got on his bench. Nope, is Jerry Jeudy out? I don't know. Yeah, I guess, okay. That's his best line. Then you got Spawn. Murray's been this year. John Taylor, he's okay. Spawn actually going an interesting route with his team. He's choosing the guys who have been on my team the last couple of years. Good luck with that, with John Taylor, Clyde Edwards-Helaire. So enjoy that. I think I might have had Mark Andrews. I don't remember. I have a lot of leagues. Anyway, Davante Adams is looking for a bounce back. Cooks, Mike Williams in the... Okay. Yeah, I got to agree. He's got the Chiefs going in against Indy. I guess that would be good if... sorry, I was getting a phone call. Okay. it'd be good if Pittman wasn't playing for Indy. I think he is going to be in... Man, that's enough. Close games this week. I'm gonna give it to I'm gonna have to give it to Spawn, man. I do not like that start of Carson Wentz. It's too scary. He's been killing it this year, but Carson Wentz, as soon as you trust him, he just turns right to trash. So that's what did it for me there. 4 score and 7 beers ago, our final matchup. He's 1-1 against them big ass TDs, man. Fucking strong matchup here. 116-113 is the projection in Jeremy's favor. Let's go over the fucking Rastas. Mahomes, Fournette, Javonte, goddamn, Debo, AJ Brown, Zach Ertz. I mean, I guess everyone's tight end is pretty weak this year, unless you drafted Travis Kelce, even though he's not really helping much, because you suck. Jalen Waddle blew up last week. Saints against Carolina is a great matchup there. Josh Allen, not bad. I think Dalvin Cook is going to fucking blow up this week. I think he's going to come out and have like fucking 30 points if I had to guess. I don't know. It's either that or he's going to blow his ACL. It's one of the two. Sanders, DeMarc. I got it. I'm going to go Shane. I don't really have to see much more. CeeDee Lamb's a little bit of weak sauce, but I like Shane's lineup. Curtis Samuel's been doing great this year. He's got the Bills going. Oh, Bills against Miami. That is interesting. I get it. The Bills are looking real good, but Miami did look good. It's at Miami. I don't know about that one. I would look for a better matchup on defense, but I get it because the Bills are a good defense, and if they go off, then you know, hate yourself. So, understandable. Packers against Tampa, you might want to go that route. We have no receiving. We have no receiving core at all. But... all right, that was all the matchups. Did I pick a winner? Yeah, Shane. Shane and them big-ass titties are going to win this week. Sorry, still 17 minutes. I tried. Can't help myself, you know? I just like hearing myself talk. Anyway, I'm waiting for that blockbuster trade with Chris and Bobby and all that. Haven't seen that yet. I think a lot of it has to do with the fact that everyone has remained relatively healthy. No real major crazy injury concerns. So, anyway, I won't, you know, waste any more of your time. Good luck to all of you. I love you, boys. Peace!